I guess the motivating goal is to understand the brain, and that's a very ambitious and somewhat vague task, but it's pretty clear from other areas of science and biology and technology that the process of understanding how something works really always benefits from understanding the components. And that's why the identification of cell types is such a critical part of really understanding how the brain functions.
Scientists have been trying to understand the diversity of cell types in the human brain for hundreds of years, and morphology has been the most reliable way to do that.
By systematically collecting a lot of data, especially the very well correlated morphology, electrophysiology, and molecular profiling data, that give us a very good chance to do the reverse engineering to understand what will be the developmental history of the cell.
Original model for identifying a cell type was looking through a microscope and maybe seeing a pyramidal shape and then having a word to describe what those cells looked like. And that goes back, you know, over 100 years and really was originally based on looking through a microscope and writing something down.
The most traditional way to describe neuron morphology has been to draw them. So we used to do it by hand, just using pen and paper, and now we take a high-resolution image and then use software to then draw them in a digital environment. In order to be able to get many, many neurons reconstructed, we need to have as much help as possible from a computer so that we can generate these reliable, accurate representations of the structure of the neuron. That's where we want to be, to have the computer do the work and have less manual intervention. What we do at the Allen Institute that's a little different than what most people do with these is we will actually take a three-dimensional image and then we'll do our reconstructions of the neurons based on those digital images. So we have some really great software, Va3D with a Mosaic user interface, where we start with an automated tracing of the neuron that's generated by an algorithm, and then using that same tool we can add to that neuron using semi-automated reconstruction, where we basically draw a branch and then the computer will figure out where within the three-dimensional space of the image that drawing should go.
Va3D is a piece of software that allows us to convert and see a stack of images in 3D, and then where it's really nice, it allows us to trace or reconstruct the cell with minimal manual efforts. It's essentially like drawing your finger along the branch, and then a reconstruction or a skeleton shows up along where we drew.
The FMOS data basically will be some of the first descriptions of brain-wide single-cell morphology. For a long time, people have been describing the morphology of neurons based on what they see in just a thin section of the neuron. But now we have the technology that allows us to take these high-resolution images, and then we can look at the morphology of the neuron across the entire brain.
The methods that we have now, they provide a starting point for the reconstruction, and there are gaps. Part of that is the quality of the experiment, but also, you know, there are gaps in what the reconstruction provides, and it would be great if we could fill those gaps and make it more of a totally fully automated process where maybe our team is just responsible for doing a quick check before it gets uploaded to the website.
The reason why we want to move to the fully automatic reconstruction is really because of the scale of the problems. To really understand how many types of neurons out there, as well as the connectivity map of these neurons, we need to have big sample numbers to accomplish such a task. Tomography has been a tremendous useful tool for understanding synaptic molecular profiles. Its pioneer, Professor Stephen Smith, continued his work here by collaborating with the morphology reconstruction groups. He actually provides very valuable data with the goal to reconstruct very complicated circuits. we have achieved preliminarily better results for the array tomography data. And our plan for the next phase is that to scale up this test on very large scale to achieve our milestones for the circuit reconstruction.
So the project I'm working on is called SmartScope. And SmartScope is an automated two-photon microscope that uses online image analysis to generate neuron reconstructions. SmartScope solves two problems. One problem is that imaging the entire sample takes a lot of time. And SmartScope solves that problem by reducing the imaging volume to contain only the signal that we're interested in. And the other problem it solves is the generation of the reconstruction. So by reconstructing each tile as we go, as we scan over the whole neuron, we actually generate a reconstruction in the same process.
MOSAC is a game that's designed to engage citizen scientists. Working with Zoran Popovich at the University of Washington, he and other individuals at the Institute came up with a way to basically create a game that would allow citizens to start reconstructing neurons, start correcting reconstructions, and it allows citizens to get a sense about the kind of data that is important for understanding the brain and to directly contribute to generating that data.
To move the neuroscience forward, people need different resources. Okay. People need the data. People need to have their good anchor point. Okay. So the very valuable resource produced by the Allen Institute, they serve as the critical anchor point for people to understand where they are, okay, and where they can go. And neuron morphology certainly play a substantial role in this particular effort.
Having a large number of reconstructions that represents the full diversity of the cell types that are in the brain, and to be able to describe not just their local morphology, but also their long-range projections, will be able to build models of the brain that have a level of accuracy and a level of completeness that we've never been able to achieve before.